and thin of an enviable height. And I've been known to be quite handsome in a certain angle and a certain light. Well, I entered into O'Malley's, said, "O'Malley, I have a thirst." O'Malley merely smiled at me, said, "You wouldn't be the first." I knocked on the bar and pointed to a bottle on the shelf. And as O'Malley poured me out a drink, I sniffed and crossed myself. My hand decided that the time was nigh, and for a moment it slipped from view. Oh, when it returned, it to fairly burned with confidence in you. Oh, the thunder from my steely fist made all the glasses jangle. Oh, when I shot him, I was so handsome. It was the light, it was the anger. I cried, friends, I screamed, I banged my fists upon the bar. I bear no grudge against you, and my dick felt long and hard. I am the man for which you know God waits, but for which the whole world yearns. And I'm marked by darkness and by blood and by a thousand powder burns. Well, you know those fish with the swollen lips that clean the ocean floors. When I looked at poor old O'Malley's wife, well, that's exactly what I saw. When I jammed the barrel under her chin, and her face looked raw and vicious. Her head, it landed in the sink with all the dirty dishes. And her daughter, Siobhan, I pulled bears from dusk till dawn. Amongst the town folks, she was a bit of a joke, but she pulled the best beer in town. Well, I swooped magnificent upon her. She sat shivering in her grief, like the Madonna painted on the church house wall in whale's blood and banana leaves. Her throat crumbled in my hands, and I spun heroically around to see Caffrey rising from his seat. I shot that motherfucker down. Flew about the murder. Mrs. Richard Holmes, she screamed, "You really should have heard her." Well, I sang and I laughed, I held and I wept, I painted like a pup. I blew a hole in Mrs. Richard Holmes, and her husband stupidly stood up. You are an evil man, and I paused a while to wonder, if I have no free will, then how can I be morally culpable? I wonder. I shot Richard Holmes in the stomach. Ginger Lee, he sat down and he whispered weirdly, no offense, then lay upon the ground. None taken, I replied to him, to which he gave a little cough. And with blazing wings, I neatly aimed, blew his head completely off. I've lived in this town for 30 years. To know what I am, a stranger. And I put new bullets in my gun, a chamber upon chamber. And I turned my gun on the bird like Mr. Brooks. I thought of St. Francis and his sparrows. And as I shot down the youthful Richardson, it was Sebastian I thought of and his arrows. I want to introduce myself, and I'm glad that you all came. And I leapt up on the bar and I shouted out my name. While Jerry bellows, he hugged his stool, closed his eyes and shrugged and laughed. And with an ashtray big as a fucking really big brick, I spat, split his skull in half. His blood spilled across the bar like a steaming scarlet brook. And in a note there at its edge on the counter, wiped my tears away and looked. Well, the light in there was blinding, full of God and ghosts and truth. And I smiled at Henry Davenport, who made no attempt to move. Well, from the position I was standing, the strangest thing I ever saw, the bullet entered through the top of his chest and blew his bowels out on the floor. And I floated down the counter, showing no remorse. I shot a hole in Kathleen Carpenter, recently divorced. The remorse I felt, remorse I had, it clung to everything. From the raven hair up on my head to the feathers on my wing. Claw with its gold hairless chest, and I glided through the bodies and killed the fat man Vincent Wells, who sat quietly in his chair, a man become a child. And I raised the gun up to his head, executioner style. He made attempt to resist, so fat and dull and lazy. Did you know that I live in your street, I said, and he looked at me like I was crazy. Oh, he said I had no idea, and he grew as quiet as a mouse. While the roar of the pistol, when it went up, and he blew the hat right off the hat. Uh-uh. gave it a long and loving inspection. There stands some kind of man, I roared, and they did in the reflection. My hair combed back like a raven's wing, and my muscles hard and tight. And curling from the business end of my gun was a query mark of cordite. Well, I spun to the left, I spun to the right, I spun to the left again. Fear me, fear me, fear me, but no one did, 'cause they were dead. Sirens wailing, and then a bullhorn squelched and blared. Drop your weapons and come out with your hands held in the air. Well, I checked the chamber of my gun, so I had one final bullet left. My hand, it looked almost human as I raised it bravely to my head. Drop your weapon and come on out. Keep your hands above your head. I had one long, hard think about dying and did exactly what they said. There must have been 50 cops out there in a circle around O'Malley's bar. Don't shoot, I cried, I'm a man unarmed. So they put me in a car, and they sped me away from that terrible scene. And I glanced out of the window, saw O'Malley's bar, saw the cops and the cars, and I started counting on my fingers. Mm-hmm.